eligibility, entry date, deferrals, contributions, distributions, the list can really go on and on. And what does it really mean? These are common questions employees have as they make the decision to enroll in their company's retirement plan. I know from experience that becoming a participant in a retirement plan comes with a lot of confusing, but really important information. The Summary Plan Description, or SPD, is such an important tool for participants to get a real understanding of how their company's retirement plan works. What is the SPD, and why is it so important to your participants? Well, let's take Joe Brown from the construction company, EEK. Joe has met all the requirements to be able to contribute to his company's retirement plan, but now what? Understanding how the plan works is vital for him to make an informed decision about enrolling into the plan. This is where the SPD can come in. The SPD is a detailed but very easily understood summary describing the retirement plan's provisions. Everything from the name and type of plan to eligibility requirements, contribution types, and the methods used to calculate employer contributions. ERISA requires that participants and beneficiaries receive an SPD within 90 days of becoming an eligible employee. When there's a new plan established, SPDs must be delivered within 120 days after the effective date. After reviewing the SPD and discussing enrollment with his financial advisor and HR department, Joe decides to enroll in the construction company's retirement plan and is excited to start saving. At some point after Joe's entry date, the plan sponsor decides to amend the adoption agreement to change the retirement plan's loan options. Currently, the plan does not allow for loans. With the new amendment, participants are now eligible to take a loan out of approved sources. These changes to the adoption agreement directly affect the SPD. Each time a change is made, participants must be notified, and this is a summary of material modification, or an SMN. Per ERISA guidelines, this must be delivered within 210 days after the end of the plan year in which it was made. Administering a retirement plan has a lot of moving pieces, especially when it comes to keeping up with all the requirements. Working with your TPA and a financial advisor to understand how each role impacts these requirements may make these moving pieces seem like a well-oiled machine.